Good morning, everyone. Seven Lives International School welcomes you all. I am Jaisal Khakkar. I am the HR teacher of Grade 3 Orchid, and I will be teaching Maths and English in Grade 3 Orchid and Maths and Humanities in Grade 3 Tulip. Today, in this orientation session, I will brief you about English, Maths, and Humanities. First, let me start with English. Objectives of learning English language involves mastering of four important skills, that is listening, speaking, reading and writing. Grade 3 will have three English books, that is Oxford English for Cambridge Primary Student Book, Workbook and Cambridge Care. Students will also have to maintain 200 pages notebook for classwork, homework and class test. Grade 3 students will have internal assessment twice in a year of 30 marks each, one in term 1 and the other in term 2. These marks will be added in the term exams. Internal assessment criteria for English in term 1 and 2 are listening test for 5 marks, speaking test 5 marks, 5 marks for reading test, and class test will be of 15 marks. In case of offline exams, unit 1 and 2 will be of 35 marks, and for term 1 and 2, theory paper, which will be divided into English 1 and English 2 of 35 marks each, total will be 70 marks, and internal assessment of 30 marks. In case of online exams, in unit 1 and 2, theory paper will be of 20 marks and orals will carry 5 marks. For term 1 and 2, theory paper, which will be divided into English 1 and English 2 of 35 marks each, total will be 70 marks, internal assessment of 30 marks and 20 marks for oral. So total comes to 120 marks, which will be converted to 100 marks. So this is all about English curriculum and assessment. Next is maths. Mathematics is more than just a collection of right answers to questions posed by someone. Objectives of learning maths are understanding the approach used to solve the problem, usage of appropriate operations, quick and accurate calculations, and applying concepts to real life situations. Grade 3 will have two maths book, namely Collins International Primary Maths Student Book and Workbook. Students will have to maintain 100 pages square line notebook for classwork, homework and class test. Internal assessment criteria for maths are timely submission of classwork, homework and worksheets, 5 marks. Project will carry 5 marks. Mental maths will be of 5 marks and 15 marks for class test. The assessment pattern for maths will be the same as that of English. Now we come to my last subject, that is humanities. It is said that the more you know about the past, the better prepared you are for the future. TRED Primary Social Studies is introduced in Grade 3 to enrich human values along with acquiring the civic sense and becoming aware of various geographical features. Apart from the textbook, children will have to maintain 200 pages notebook for classwork and tests. Students are evaluated on the basis of following components for internal assessment. Classwork, homework and worksheets will carry 5 marks, 10 marks for project, and class test will be of 15 marks. In case of offline exam, unit test 1 and 2 will be of 25 marks. For term 1 and 2, theory paper will be of 70 marks and internal assessment of 30 marks, that comes to 100 marks. In case of online exam, in unit 1 and 2, theory paper will be of 20 marks and 5 marks will be for orals. For term 1 and 2, theory paper will be of 70 marks, internal assessment 30 marks, and 20 marks for oral. Total comes to 120 marks, which will be converted to 100 marks. Please note that in case of any absenteeism, retest will not be taken for any assessment. So this is all about English, Maths and Humanities curriculum and assessment. If you have any queries, write a mail to me at jaisalkhakkar@gmail.com. I wish you a safe and a healthy year ahead.
Suprabhat. मैं आपके सामने वार्षिक योजना लेकर प्रस्तुत हुई हूँ। मेरा नाम चंदा मिश्रा है, मैं हिंदी की शिक्षिका हूँ और हिंदी हमारी राष्ट्रभाषा है। देश विदेश में भी जाकर हम हिंदी भाषा बोलकर अपने कार्यों को संपन्न कर सकते हैं। और मैं आपको ग्रेड 3 की टेक्स्ट बुक के बारे में, किताबों के बारे में आपको जानकारी देना चाहती हूँ। नूतन सरल हिंदी माला और व्यवहारिक व्याकरण तथा रचना, इस तरह से हमारी दो किताबें हैं। नंबर 1 किताब है जो हमारी सरल हिंदी माला, उसमें आपको सभ्यता, देशभक्ति, अपनापन, एकता और त्योहारों के बारे में बहुत सारी बातें बताई गई हैं। जैसे कि हम इसमें देख सकते हैं बहुत सारी कहानियां हैं, बहुत सारी कविताएं हैं जो हमको प्रेरणा देंगी। उसी तरह से हमारी जो व्याकरण की जो टेक्स्ट बुक है, व्यवहारिक व्याकरण तथा रचना, ये टेक्स्ट बुक का हमारे नाम है, जो आपको भाषा, वर्णमाला, मात्राएँ, संज्ञा, सर्वनाम, वाचन, क्रिया, इस तरह से आपको इसमें दिया गया है। ओके, और आपको मैं बताना चाहती हूँ कि टर्म 1 एंड टर्म 2 में आपके इंटरनल असाइनमेंट होते हैं, जो आंतरिक मूल्यमापन होता है, जिसे हम टर्म 1 एंड टर्म 2 में हम प्लस करके बच्चों को मार्क्स देते हैं। जैसे कि रीडिंग, लिसनिंग, स्पीकिंग, इस तरह से होते हैं 5-5 मार्क्स के, जिसे हम हिंदी में वाचन, सूत्र लेखन और संभाषण कहते हैं। कक्षा टेस्ट भी हमारा 15 मार्क्स के होते हैं। और मैं अभी आपको बताना चाहती हूँ कि हमारे जो ऑनलाइन ऑफलाइन एग्ज़ाम होने वाले हैं, उनके बारे में आपको कुछ साझा करना चाहती हूँ। यूनिट टेस्ट 1 एंड यूनिट टेस्ट 2 थियरी पेपर 20 मार्क्स, और टर्म 1 एंड टर्म 2 थियरी पेपर 70 और आईमो के मार्क्स 13, सब मिला के 100 मार्क्स के होते हैं। और ऑनलाइन हमारा जो एग्ज़ाम होगा वो यूनिट टेस्ट 1 एंड यूनिट टेस्ट 2 थियरी पेपर 20 मार्क्स प्लस 5 ओरल मार्क्स। ओके, एंड टर्म 1 एंड टर्म 2 थियरी पेपर 70, आईमो के मार्क्स 30 एंड 20 मार्क्स के ओरल के मार्क्स होंगे, 120 मार्क्स के ये पूरे क्वेश्चन होंगे। और मैं आपसे एक बात साझा करना चाहती हूँ कि यदि आप का बच्चा अनुपस्थिति होता है किसी एग्ज़ाम के दौरान, तो हम फिर से एग्ज़ाम नहीं ले सकते हैं। बहुत बड़ा कोई कारण होगा तो सोच सकते हैं। ओके, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका इस वार्षिक योजना के साथ। हेल्दी रहिए, सुखी रहिए।
नमस्कार, मी नीली माणिकू, मराठी विषयाची विषय शिक्षिका। आज आपण इयत्ता 2 व 3 याकरता असणारा अभ्यासक्रम व मूल्यमापन बघणार आहोत। प्रथम इयत्ता 2 करिता असणारा अभ्यासक्रम, इयत्ता 2 मध्ये विविध मात्रांचा समावेश करण्यात आला आहे। म्हणजे विद्यार्थ्यांना प्रथम काना, मात्रा, वेलांटी, उकार कधी द्यावी, कोणत्या स्वराचा उच्चार झाल्यानंतर कोणत्या प्रकारची मात्रा द्यावी याविषयी शिकविले जाईल, आणि त्यानंतर त्यांची पूर्ण 12 घेण्यात येईल। 12 झाल्यानंतर आपले शरीर, आपले अवयव, आपले कुटुंब, माझी शाळा याविषयी त्यांना छोटे छोटे असे धडे असणार आहे। या धड्यांची उत्तरं काही प्रमाणात त्यांना तोंडी द्यायची आहेत किंवा लहान लहान उत्तरं ती त्यांना लेखी स्वरूपात परीक्षेला विचारल्या जातात। अशा प्रकारचा अभ्यासक्रम पूर्ण वर्षभरामध्ये आपल्याला पूर्ण करायचा आहे। नंतर त्यांचे मूल्यमापन, इयत्ता 2 करिता प्रथम चाचणी, प्रथम सत्र, द्वितीय चाचणी, द्वितीय सत्र अशा 4 प्रकारच्या परीक्षा असणार आहे। इयत्ता 2 करिता मराठी विषयाचे मूल्यमापन करण्यात येणार आहे। प्रत्येक प्रथम चाचणी व द्वितीय चाचणी अनुक्रमे 20-20 गुणांची असणार आहे, तर प्रथम सत्र व द्वितीय सत्र 40-40 गुणांची असणार आहे। याबरोबरच त्यांना आंतरिक मूल्यमापनाकरता लेखन, भाषण व वाचन याकरता प्रत्येकी 5 गुण, अशा प्रकारचे 15 गुण व क्लास टेस्टचे मिळून 15 गुण असे 30 गुणांचे आंतरिक मूल्यमापन प्रत्येक सत्रामध्ये करण्यात येणार आहे। अशाच प्रकारे इयत्ता 3 अभ्यासक्रम पाहूया। इयत्ता 3 मध्ये लहान लहान प्रमाणात धडे असणार आहे, जे आपल्या निसर्गाशी निगडीत किंवा आजूबाजूच्या परिसराशी, आपल्या कुटुंबाशी निगडीत किंवा खेळण्यांशी निगडीत असे छोटे छोटे धडे, गोष्टी, कविता असणार आहे। गोष्टी त्यांना अभिनय रूपाने शिकविण्यात येतील व गोष्टींवर अभिनय कसा करायचा या प्रकारचे शिक्षण सुद्धा त्यांना देण्यात येईल. त्यानंतर त्यांना स्त्रीलिंग, पुल्लिंग, नपुंसकलिंग, विविध प्रकारच्या दिशा कोणत्या आहेत, नंतर वचन अशा विरुद्धार्थी शब्द, समानार्थी शब्द अशा प्रकारचं व्याकरणाचा सुद्धा समावेश करण्यात आला आहे. यांचे मूल्यमापन कसे होणार ते पाहूया आपण. यांना इयत्ता तिसरीला मूल्यमापन हे परीक्षा असणार आहे. इयत्ता तिसरीकरिता प्रथम सत्र, द्वितीय सत्र, प्रथम चाचणी व द्वितीय चाचणी या अनुक्रमे असणार आहेत. प्रथम चाचणी व द्वितीय चाचणी ही 25-25 गुणांची, तर प्रथम सत्र व द्वितीय सत्र 70-70 गुणांची परीक्षा असणार आहे. आणि लेखन, वाचन व भाषण यांना अनुक्रमे 5-5 गुण देऊन व क्लास टेस्ट यांचे 15 गुण अशा प्रकारे 30 गुणांचे अंतर्गिक मूल्यमापन सुद्धा असणार आहे. या अंतर्गिक मूल्यमापन त्यांचं प्रत्येक सत्रामध्ये होणार आहे. अशा प्रकारे इयत्ता दुसरी व तिसरीचं अभ्यासक्रम व मूल्यमापन आपण पाहिले आहे. धन्यवाद.
गुड मॉर्निंग डिअर पेरेंट्स, आय होप यू ऑल आर फाईन अँड इन गुड हेल्थ. माय नेम इज अदिती शिवणगीकर अँड आय एम गोईंग टू बी द होमरूम टीचर फॉर ग्रेड 3 ट्यूलिप. आय विल बी द सायन्स टीचर फॉर ग्रेड 3 ट्यूलिप अँड ग्रेड 3 ऑर्किड. आय टेक दिस अपॉर्च्युनिटी टू एक्सप्लेन सम ऑफ द बेसिक प्रोटोकॉल दॅट वी आर गोईंग टू फॉलो फॉर द सब्जेक्ट सायन्स थ्रू आउट दिस इयर. आय एम शुअर स्टुडंट्स मस्ट बी रेडी विथ ग्रेट एन्थुझियाझम फॉर दिस न्यू अकॅडमिक सेशन. For grade 3, there will be total 6 lessons. There are 6 lessons in the syllabus. That includes looking after plants, looking after ourselves, sense organs, characteristics of living beings, investigating materials and forces and movement. All these lessons have lot of practicals. There are lot of activities that we will be carrying out during this academic year. For example, looking after plants, in this lesson we will be growing plants and students will be able to understand the desirable conditions that are necessary for growth of a plant. When we design this objective of this science subject, we basically classify it into 4 categories. First is concept. Students should be able to understand the concept. Next is application of the concept in actual day-to-day life. Then it is scientific aptitude. Development of scientific aptitude is very important. And finally, it is environmental sensitivity. Students should be able to correlate what they have understood and they should be able to follow it in their day-to-day life. For example, electricity. If they are learning about topic electricity, they should be able to understand that electricity should be saved, water should be saved, like this. Now, let me also explain about exam criteria. There will be 2 semesters. In each semester, there will be 1 unit test and 1 term exam each. If the school is offline, unit test will carry theory paper 20 marks, which will be further converted to 100 marks. If the school is online, then unit test paper will be of 20 marks and 5 marks will be given to orals. That also will be converted to 100 marks. Talking about term exams, there will be term exam, theory paper 70 marks and 30 marks internal assessment, total 100 marks in case of offline school. In case of online school, theory paper will be of 70 marks, internal assessments 30 marks and orals will be there. There will be orals for 20 marks. Total it will be 120 marks. Talking more about internal assessment carries 30 marks. We have class test for 15 marks, then remaining 15 marks are further classified as worksheets, classwork, homework, participation in the class such as oral questions will be asked to them. Also, they will be asked to perform some of the practicals as I told, and then there will be some model making, chart making. All these activities in total together will carry 15 marks. Generally, I would like to suggest that we all should encourage our children to participate, be interactive in the class, be attentive in the class, and of course I know they will be doing the same. Talking about notebooks, दे विल बी रिक्वायरिंग टू नोटबुक्स 100 पेजेस ईच वन फॉर ईच सेमेस्टर. वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर दिस न्यू एकेडमिक सेशन. वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स. थैंक यू.
Hello parents, I am Ms. Vaishali Kalvi and I will be teaching ICT to grade 3 Tulip and Pocket. ICT is Information and Communication Technology. ICT plays significant role in all aspects of modern society. We live in technology dominated world today. The structural design of this course facilitates comprehensive learning and understanding the basic concepts and application of computer science. We are using Collins Computer Craft 3 book for the subject. About assessment, there will be two unit tests and two term exams. If the exams are offline, then unit test will be of 25 marks, which will be then converted to 100 marks. And in case of term exams, the written paper will be of 70 marks plus 30 marks internal assessment. So total 100 marks. Now if the exams are online, then unit tests will be of 20 marks plus 5 marks oral. So total 25, and these 25 will then convert it to 100. In case of online term exams, the written paper will be of 70 marks plus 30 marks internal assessment plus 20 marks oral. So total 120 marks, and these 120 marks will then convert it to 100 marks. Now internal assessment of ICT. Internal assessment of ICT will include class test, project, orals, classwork, homework, assignments, worksheets, etc. And hence the students should attend the classes regularly, join the classes on time. Project, homework, worksheet submission should be done on time. So this was all about ICT. If you have any query, you can send an email to me at vaishali.sicis@gmail.com. Thank you.
Good morning. I am Anju Sibyl and I will be teaching the art and design subject. Art and design helps a child to develop the fine motor skills by improving their hand and eye coordination, which is very important. The more they practice to draw lines and figures, the faster they can improve their drawing, coloring and handwriting skills. Art will be integrated with different subjects which will make their concepts clear. Children will be learning different type of drawings this year from Warli, geometric figures, human figures and still life. This year, children can use oil pastels of 15 or 25 shades. Children can really improve their drawing by doing one direction coloring whenever they do the coloring, and children should remember one point that whenever they do the drawing, they have to give very less pressure to the hand. As far as parents are concerned, they can always encourage the children by motivating them by giving positive remarks, and they can buy some coloring books of their choice. Thank you.
My name is Mr. Dinesh Patil. I teach physical education in Seven Isles International School for students of grade 1 to 5. Our school gives much importance to the sports because its play major part improving your physical and mental fitness, also helps in developing your self-confidence, team spirit and mentally and physical toughness. Due to this current situation of pandemic, offline classes are not possible, so in online classes I teach standing yoga, sitting yoga, power yoga as well as various exercises such as partlet training, circuit training, aerobics and other fun games. When the offline school will resume, I will also teach students outdoor games such as cricket, football, handball, basketball and athletics, as well as indoor games such as chess, carrom and table tennis. I'll also be conducted Dioso game, Relax Foundation, athletics game and different types of online sports competition. Till then, stay happy and healthy. Thank you.
Hey Ishvara Sarvana, Sangli Buddhi De, Arogya De, सर्वाना सुखात आनंदात ऐश्वर्यात ठेव, सर्वांच भल कर, कल्याण कर, रक्षण कर, आणि तुझे गोड नाम मुखात अखंड राहू दे. हॅलो एव्हरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर सिद्धेश गंधट. आय वुड लाईक टू स्पीक ऑन म्युझिक. फर्स्ट, वॉट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह ऑफ म्युझिक? म्युझिक हॅज मल्टिपल साईड इफेक्ट ऑन द ह्युमन बॉडी. म्युझिक इज अ मिडियम ऑफ आउटवर्ड ऍक्टिव्हिटी अँड इनवर्ड एक्सपिरियन्स. इट हॅज डिरेक्ट रिलेशन टू स्पीच अँड लँग्वेज विथ कम्युनिकेशन थ्रू बॉडीली एक्सप्रेशन अँड डान्स टू अ रेंज ऑफ इमोशन अँड टू द परसेप्शन अँड रेकॉग्निशन ऑफ साऊंड पॅटर्न्स अँड फॉर्म्स. Let me make one announcement. While school was working offline, we used to conduct music celebration in the classroom. But due to pandemic situation, henceforth we will be conducting music celebration grade-wise through Facebook and YouTube. Now let's talk about the syllabus content of our school. While studying the Cambridge IGCSE music syllabus, learners listen to perform and compose music, encouraging aesthetic and emotional development, self-discipline and creativity. This gives them appreciation and enjoyment of music. Research on speech skills focuses on rhythm and perception. It also gives an idea of accent of and fluency. While learning music, speech skills are very important. Primarily, it is used for recreation, for self-expression, improvement of speech and language development. It also provides personal satisfaction and source of social pleasure. Now, let's talk about vocal accuracy. Vocal accuracy are early vocal training, appropriate models and feedback, and instrumental or accompaniment. Additional time with daily vocal exercise and vocal assembles. Breathe is very important in vocal music, like ability to cope with breathing patterns while singing in a group. Auditory skills are of great importance. It is complex task of listening and can become highly structured. It gives natural motivation of using residual hearing. Last but not the least, social skills. It contains group music, promotes sharing, mutual attentiveness, responsibility to the group, an enjoyable sense of partnership in activities that demand a cooperative effort for successful accomplishment. I conclude my words by this famous quote: music washes away from the soul the dust of everyday life. For any queries, kindly mail me at siddesh.sics@gmail.com. Thank you, everyone.